There once was a story of a boy and a girl. Their names were Romeo and Juliet. Their love was a twirl. One was a Montague, one was a Capulet, which made them not work as a duet. He fell head over heels for a girl that wasn't allowed. She was a Capulet too. Her name was Rosaline, which meant Romeo was in a bind. He couldn't decide what to do, so his good friend Mercutio told him what to do. Go to a ball, he said, that'll help you. He had his eye on that girlie, then his fate changed. He saw little Juliet, and then his mind suddenly changed. There was this other guy, though. His name was Paris. He wanted Juliet's hand in marriage. Except Romeo and Juliet danced the night away, and then he kissed her farewell till the very next day. Love at first sight is kind of a bite. They talked on the balcony that very night. They decided to sneak away and get married the very next day. They didn't tell their parents, though, because they knew they'd feel disobeyed. Little did they know, Tybalt was on his way to slay her Romeo on their wedding day. But Mercutio and Benvolio were there to save the day, but instead of saving the day, Mercutio got slayed. Along came Romeo, head filled with steam, ready to fight Tybalt, who made this big scene. Sad to say, when Juliet heard the news, she was in dismay, thinking her Romeo was the one who didn't get away, but only to find out it was Tybalt who got slayed. She had yet to find out her love had been banished from Verona there, forever there to stay. They both thought this was worse than death. They wanted to take their lives and get away from the pain, thinking being in heaven together would be a better way. Then the friar came to Juliet with a plan. Say you'll marry Paris, then take this potion to make you seem dead. I will send word to Romeo of our plan. I'll be there with Romeo when you wake up from being dead. Unexpectedly, though, their plans were changed when Father Capulet decided to move the wedding up one day. Juliet took the potion to put the plan in motion. Little did she know, Mr. Romeo wouldn't get the notion. That is, Juliet wasn't really dead. It was just a little trick to everybody's head. Thinking that his Juliet was dead, he went to Verona to say his last goodbyes to his one true love. Bye, bye, bye. Paris and him got in a fight over Juliet's body, saying goodnight. Romeo warned Paris, I'm not here to fight, just to say goodbye one last time. Paris didn't listen and started a fight, then lost his life. Romeo was missing his wife, so he took his very own life. Juliet awakens in disbelief to find her Romeo as cold as concrete. Juliet's pain was too much to bear, so she stabbed herself. Wait, what? Where? In her heart, that's where. Paris, Romeo, Juliet all dead. Their parents come down to see all this dread. Feeling lonely and sad, they bow their heads. Seeing how much Romeo and Juliet loved one another, they stopped their feud and started to love one another. Peace on land and no more feuding. Love each other, man. Word!
There once was a story.